Hello friends, welcome to AI Flux. So NVIDIA just broke an incredible record and proved again that they have some of the best GPUs for AI in the entire world. To set this benchmark, NVIDIA combined 3,584 H100 GPUs using a cloud provider called CoreWeave, and they tried to see how quickly they could train all of GPT3, which is an early version of ChatGPT from OpenAI. And we'll talk about the third-party org that actually benchmarked this in just a bit. But they compared what this massive number of H100 GPUs could do compared to a similar number of NVIDIA A100 80-gig cards and V100 GPUs, which were the state-of-the-art basically 3 years and about 6 years ago. And what was wild is the H100s were able to train all of GPT-3 in just 46 hours. Which is just completely insane. The comparison with the A100s is the A100s took about 36 days. So what's wild is the H100s, although it's the same number of physical GPUs actually consuming less power, were almost 20 times faster than the previous state of the art, which is completely insane. The V100s actually took 51 days. So again, this is a pretty large cluster. Most people actually can't really even imagine the cost of having 3,500 of the most advanced GPUs available to man today. However, this advancement poses some interesting questions, and knowing what we know now from NVIDIA, we can actually extract some really interesting insights here. The first being, a lot of people ask, well, can AMD even compete with this? And although the time of this happening is impressive, right? 46 hours for this massive model that took almost 2 months to train just 5 years ago. The question here is what made this possible? And the real answer is not just the GPUs, it's the platform, the networking, and the software that is all created and curated by NVIDIA that makes all of this possible. So although AMD has some interesting new accelerators that have come out, like the MI-2500 and 3000, the difference here is that even if the GPUs are fast, the industry standard is NVIDIA. The best software is NVIDIA, and the best developers are using that. So if you're going to go out and pick this, you know, it is a bit of a risk and it is different. And even if the performance is the same, this kind of benchmarking has actually not even been shown to work on AMD yet. So interesting there. The other curious thing with AMD is that now that they're trying to be sort of more serious about this, it actually strengthens NVIDIA's position because it makes NVIDIA look like less of a monopoly in terms of their capabilities in the AI space. There's some other questions as well. So one is Moore's Law actually getting faster? And what's curious about this is Moore's Law technically has slowed down. So the cost and the relative density of 1 teraflop of compute with GPUs has not moved by much. It's moved slower than it has in decades past. However, the important thing is not necessarily compute density or how much energy we're consuming, but it's how well it scales. And for the first time, NVIDIA has shown that with their highest-end GPUs, and most importantly, their new InfiniBand interface, which is a bunch of fiber optics that connect all these GPUs together so you can sort of treat them as one massive GPU, they've achieved near linear scaling. So if you compare 50 H100s to 100 H100s, linear scaling means that the 100 H100s is twice as fast as 50. And if you then add on another 100, then 200 H100s will be twice as fast as 100 H100s. And for those of us who remember back when NVIDIA SLI was a thing, you could have up to 4 GTX 580s put together, or 2 GTX 590s, which were back when we had dual GPU cards. And you'll remember that 2 GPUs would give you, in gaming, you know, maybe a 40% performance boost over a single GPU. Adding a third was, you know, a paltry, maybe 12 to 14%. And if you were just baller and you had enough money to buy 4 GTX 580s, the fourth full GTX 580 in most games would maybe only give you another 8% performance increase, usually less. And that's an example of scaling that is not linear. So basically, as you add more cards, the returns are diminishing with each additional card. And that's why this is nuts. NVIDIA has shown, yeah, we can get 3,500 of these together and achieve near linear scaling. So if you have 6,000, you know, the limitation really then lands on how much energy you have, how much space you have in the building, and the breaking points of NVIDIA's InfiniBand interface, which again is why they made huge investments in Mellanox, which was a company that only made networking infrastructure. The other cool thing is this was not trained on an HPC cluster. This is actually a dynamically allocated cluster from a cloud provider called CoreWeave that actually specializes in GPU clusters. Another thing that I think is important to mention is the benchmark used here is a benchmark from an independent organization called MLPerf. So every year they come together and they create a number of generalized sort of heterogeneous benchmarks that they think give a really good sense of, you know, if you run these at scale, of how good the hardware running them is in that year. And this could range from recurrent neural networks, GANs, LLMs, and even some generative AI stuff this year. And what's interesting is, you know, some companies that focus on bespoke accelerators. So for instance, kind of like what Tesla has done, and there are some other small companies in the Bay that say, oh, well, we're going to focus on ReLUs, or we're going to focus on some specific industry segment. And it's interesting because for those of you who know what ASICs are, which are application-specific integrated circuits, so, you know, for mining, they can really only do one thing very well. And technically speaking, an NVIDIA GPU is a kind of ASIC because it just does parallel computation very well. However, they're slightly more general, and that's before you're looking at something called an FPGA, which is much slower. So NVIDIA has found a balance of these things in their silicon. And what's really cool is they actually score the best in every category of the MLPerf benchmark. This benchmark specifically is called MLPerf 3.0. And if you go to the ML Commons website, you can actually view the 3.0 results, which are all held by NVIDIA. There is actually a mixture of systems here. So there are the cloud instances. There are also the on-prem instances that are broken down by who actually built the server. So this is also kind of cool if you're someone who's making the decision to spend tens of millions or hundreds of millions of dollars on equipment. You can look at what's the best, and you can even compare it to NVIDIA's own hardware. They have the DGX H100s with a number of different CPUs. NVIDIA did not only destroy the competition in terms of the speed of training GPT-3, which I think is the most relevant here and the most understandable for, you know, our audience, but they nailed it in every single category. So the idea that there's some other company that's better than NVIDIA right now for AI is kind of a stretch. And of course, it wouldn't be 2023 if we didn't have some kind of climate angle to this. What is kind of interesting with this kind of density is you do start to see NVIDIA GPUs as one of the best options for efficiency. I do know also that Lambda has a number of H100s as well. They have, you know, low, I think like tens of thousands right now, and they're only getting larger. So again, a bit more of a technical video, but I thought this was very cool to see just because it shows how far ahead NVIDIA really is from AMD. It shows that the ecosystem NVIDIA has created here is working and is undoubtedly the best as verified by a third-party organization. So let me know what you think about the H100. I certainly can't afford one. I could sell my car and maybe take out a massive loan to buy one of these. But let me know. Some of you might have V100s at home. So yeah, very interesting, very cool stuff. So as always, I hope you learned something. If you like our content, please like and subscribe. It helps us out a ton. And we'll see you in the next video.